The Deakin Motion Lab consists of an experienced, interdisciplinary team of researchers with expertise in game design, filmmaking, 3D animation, motion capture, virtual and augmented reality, and virtual production. Because of its industry-facing research, Deakin University plays a vital role in finding creative solutions to industry problems through its extensive research and development efforts, fostering of cross-disciplinary collaboration and the education of future problem solvers.
I'm Dr. Martin Potter. I'm a senior lecturer in the School of Communication and Creative Arts at Deakin University. We're in Deakin's Motion Lab and we do a whole range of immersive visualization in this space. The project that I'm working on at the moment is called The Earth Above. It's a deep time view of Australia's epic history. What it is a planetarium feature show. So it's going to run about 25 to 30 minutes and it's going to provide audiences with an opportunity to kind of travel back through time to be able to unpack the delicate traces of these new emerging archaeological discoveries that are being made and how they're being entangled with Indigenous knowledge systems.
My name's Scott Jackson. I'm the lead animator on the Earth Above project. We're just showing how our development process with the planetarium is sort of seamless, and we can jump in VR to see a makeshift planetarium dome, and we can see a pretty accurate representation of what our experience is going to look like in a VR dome without actually having to go there. At the moment, I'm working on Clog's Cave, which tells the story of a Mulla Mullum, which is Medicine Man, and what happened in that cave, what experiences were had there, and it's all backed by sort of the research that the archaeologists are doing. When you're working with a planetarium and dome, you're obviously dealing with a 180 degree field of view, so you don't really know where the viewer's going to look at a certain time. There's all these sort of tricks that we need to have in mind when we're designing content for the dome.
It's so important to be able to actually come into a dome and see it playing back, actually being in the physical space, not just in the VR space. It's super important. It totally transforms the way that we see what we've done. It's been great to be able to have the Motion Lab as like a place where everybody can come to and we can actually have a context to make this type of stuff. Without having the lab as like a research centre, it would be very, very hard to get large-scale projects like this up. So having that kind of node of the lab is really, really important. The lab is a collaborative centre and that's really the benefit that we feel.
I'm Sean Gladwell, I'm a contemporary artist. We're getting ready to complete this work behind me, which is called Passing Electrical Storms. The inspiration for this project, it's really something that I've been thinking about for a long time in my artwork. The idea of how brief our life is, how fragile it is, our individual selves are in relation to the scale of the universe, a very humble way of trying to represent that in VR. We have 6 bays that are going to offer this VR experience. Cameras above that will then record people, and that image will then be comped into the environment, the experience. And it requires, for me, a lot of support because I don't have the specialized skill in order to actually go in and code and program VR. When I came to the NGV with my idea, they said that they had this incredible university that was really focused to innovative technology. I met the team at the lab, and Stefan and Gerard and Scott have really been central in realizing this work. All are very talented and specialized in so many different ways that the whole lab can pretty much take on, well, anything that I could throw at them in terms of a problem, creatively and technically. They not only sort of troubleshoot in this environment, but they were also integral to the process of even formulating this work. So throughout the whole process, the DML have been very much present within this work. But it's an amazing thing to have the Deakin Motion Lab actually working with me to realise a project like this.
My name is Dr. Donna McRae. I'm a senior lecturer here at Deakin University and I teach in film, TV and animation. Virtual production is like this amazing tool, but it is a tool in the portfolio of what you can use with filmmaking techniques. Well, the world opens up to you because suddenly you're not worried about weather or a truck running past when you're shooting something outside. You can control everything. It gives you the freedom to actually create what you have in your mind when you're writing the screenplay and what you see. Instead of putting the screenplay into the location, you can put the location back into the screenplay.
My name is Russell Kennedy. I'm an academic in screen and design here at Deakin University. The World Design Organization and the ISS, they invited me to a workshop. One of the briefs we were given was to look at an orbital university, to actually extend that into a research project with the DML. And the idea is to create a hypothetical or a prototype for how a orbital university might work, a project where we'll be using Unreal Engine and virtual production. Part of the research is to actually simulate microgravity from Earth so that students or researchers can get some sort of sensation of what the astronauts that who they're talking to are experiencing. Considerations of how many people fit in the room, how the lecturer or the researcher engages with the students and also the astronauts, and also the avatars which are actually teleported up to the space station. So there's a number of aspects which combine animation, virtual production, augmented reality, virtual reality, all of those components, which is what the DML specialises in, coming together to create this prototype.